Hello guys, I'm Yor, and today I'm gonna show you how to make a sound that is in my preset pack for sale at massivesynth.com. I'm sorry for my terrible Dutch accent. I can't even say that right. This is what it sounds like. Yes, so it's a melody, but in a sequencer it's just one note. It's an F, and well, that doesn't really matter, but it's an F. My tempo is at 100 BPM. Alright, and this is what it looks like in Massive. The most important thing in this preset, in the sound, are these steppers, 7 and 8. Because they make the melody, and the first stepper 7 is gonna play, and then LFO 6 is gonna switch it up, and then it's gonna continue with stepper 8. By the way, if this is not a stepper when you open Massive up, you can change that here, but I guess you know that. So LFO 6 is after two measures. It's a square wave LFO, and F2 measures is gonna change to the other stepper, because it's gonna pull this amp down and it's gonna push this amp up. So first I hear this one, right, and then this one, because then this one is muted. So how you do that? Let's go by it step by step. First, oscillator 1, sine square, wavetable position all the way to the left, intensity all the way to the right, amp all the way down. The filter is gonna go in between there. Second oscillator, grown 3, intensity all the way to the right, wavetable position. Well, you can see it yourself, and the amp all the way down. Then oscillator 3, it's a bit special too, because that's, as you can see, it does not have a performer 5 on the amp, and the amp is all the way down. Still, when I turn this macro control here, I can hear it, and that's because it's going through the bypass, and you can see that up here, and we'll get to that in a minute. So oscillator 1, you get that. Oscillator 2, then put stepper 7 in the box here, the one the one below the other, and then stepper 8 there and there. And in oscillator 3, you're gonna switch it up. Stepper 7 is going in the upper box, and 8 in the sidechain box. Then the modulation oscillator, I just use a little bit of phase. 2 octaves up, white noise, you can use that. I've put it on a macro, but it's optional. Sounds like this. I don't know if you can hear it, it's just a bit to make it a bit warmer. And the feedback, it's also on the macros and on the aftertouch, and this that's a nice thing to experiment with. If you have a keyboard with aftertouch, put it on the feedback. It gives really nice results. Don't overdo it. It can get crazy. Then insert 1, that's a delay. And dry wet all the way up, time all the way up. Insert 2 is a frequency shifter. I have that on a macro. It's not really important, but it does. What does it do? Yeah, it's just an effect. You don't have to use it. Then the filter 1 is a high pass. I push the fader all the way up. Filter 2 is a low pass, a little bit down, and the mix is gonna go in between. And it's parallel. Then envelope 1, what does it do? Oh yeah, envelope one, that's important. It's on the bypass here, and make it look like this. This white line is on the G, and this one here. Envelope two, I do not use that. Envelope three, I do use it on the frequency shifter. I think this is how it comes up, so you don't have to change anything there. And envelope four, it's like this. So performer five, that's gonna do the rhythm, and it also has LFO 6 on it. So first, the one beneath here is gonna do the rhythm, and then after two measures, it's gonna go up, and it's gonna do this rhythm. And that's all done by that beautiful LFO 6, and that should look like this. Make sure it's a square wave, so it's gonna change suddenly and not with a transition. So it's gonna flip it around really. Then this is my stepper. When you try to make melodies in the stepper, make sure you check this box snap to grid, because if you don't do that, you'll end up with these values and you don't have whole notes. And when you step to grid, you have your, well, that way you make sure you're not detuned by a few cents. Well, then this LFO 6 is gonna go on the amp, push the amp all the way up and modulation all the way down, and then stepper 8, and you do the same but then reverse. So amp is gonna go all the way down and modulation all the way up. And this is my melody there. It's not really important. You can make your own melodies, I bet. So that's that. FX1 is a delay, and FX2 is a reverb. Just copy those down. And my equalizer. It's a bit of extreme, but it works. So that's for the first two oscillators, and the third oscillator is gonna show you the routing. It's gonna go here, and then it's not gonna go through FX1, it's gonna go through FX2. So it's gonna pass the delay, go through the reverb, and then it's gonna go to, do us, yeah, I said it right. Yeah, and then it's gonna go here through insert one and then back. So that's a nice chain. I always use that, and I always put a delay in between there. You can get real kind of strange ambient bad sounds. And make sure you have it. You control the bypass here with some kind of controller. So I've put a macro control on it, but I could also do this performer, for example. You can hear it ringing out really long because of the feedback and the reverb. So I think we're almost there. Then what do we have left? We have the routing. I've shown you that. Make sure you click insert one here and feedback here. Voicing, of course, unisono up to two, monophone, pan position all the way to the left, and trigger on always. Yeah, I guess that nothing happening here. That's it. So have lots of fun with these techniques, and try to really make it your own. This one is nice. You can also do this with three steppers, for example, and then another stepper on performer five. So then first it's gonna go through stepper six, then seven, then eight. So you can make really long melodies without having to change the tempo. Yeah, that's it. Have fun with it.